We got ourselves team one together with Knuckles as a demon hunter. We got ourselves Skugar in the back as a warlock. Alphaman gonna be first up. We got ourselves Archetype as well as Copyfin on team two. We got ourselves Chicago in the back. We got Kron in the back. We got Lazy Purr. We got ourselves Snazzy as well as Sivar. Gonna be going for a polymorph for the Elfman. Hit him with Arcanus Fury, maybe the biggest one-shot birds. Elfman with a Shield of Vengeance. Gonna be Sivar with an Arcane Blast, Double Blast, Triple Blast. Elfman super low, big barrage. Elfman does go for a bit of recovery. Gonna be a little bit of missiles flying for Sivar. As Elfman got himself a Hodge, just to go behind the pillar and be a bit of a reset. Seawork did have a lot of burst there available. Man, that's actually quite a lot of burst out of Seawork. Actually kind of massive. Elfman is going to be kind of chilling over for the far side. Needs to get up close and personal with Seawork to try to get an interrupt. Going to be that Ashen. Elfman is going to get the big burst out of the Ashen. Going to be quick invis by Seawork. He knows there's an ultra time available. And he could pour it out an ultra time anytime he wants. He's going to pour back into those rune of power. Elfman get blasted out by his arcade blast. Interrupted on Shadow. Actually could be pretty bad for Elfman. Unless he's careful, he's going to go for a lot of self-healing. Looks like he was able to bank up a bit of holy power. Got him some wings and he's using the wings defensively just to live. Touch of Magic getting set up by Seawark with an Arcana Sphere. Does give himself a big go potentially? Maybe like a pseudo good go? Arcane Blast, try to see if he might be able to get himself a proc of the Necrolord. The Deathborn form. Trinkets out of that stun immediately. Elfman finds himself kind of low on health. Still has a bubble to hold on to. 1 minute left on that Shield of Vengeance, so he's not shielded for a while. Flesh cut up for Seawark as his shield is taking a bit of a beating. And Elfman with that 6% Versa is actually not too terrible. Trying to go for Dora Shadows, getting interrupted. Big missiles flying for Seawark. And Elfman going for Flash of Light just to get himself back up top top. Trying to see if he can get up next to Seawark. Just needs a little bit more damn just to get him down, man. Just a little bit more. It's going to be dropping down big hammers. Trying to get more Wakes of Ashes in. Man, if only the Paladin tier set worked. Imagine those actually Wake of Ashes. If the tier set was a little more consistent, would be amazing. But I don't think Elfman is using tier set. I think he's playing versatility better. Oh, what the? Was that even a barrage? I think it was just a touch of the Magi. I think we just see where it blasted him out and then touch of the Magi just collapsed on him. My goodness. Honestly, I'm not even sure what killed him. Was it touch of the Magi? Because touch of the Magi does accumulate some of the damage until it just blasts and crushes the target. It also does put a debuff with a two-piece tier set where you do 80% more damage to that target. Which is a nutty debuff. Gonna be another repoly onto Skugar. And Seawark is gonna be able to get a couple arcane blasts off of the pet. Get himself a little bit of runic power, holy power. I said literally everything but arcane power. God, arcane charges. But he's building up some charges. I think he's actually focusing on the pet quite a bit. Might be he's just trying to kill the pet first. It looks like he does kill the Felguard. Gonna be a second one summoned up. Is that a real Felguard? I think he just resummoned one with a Fel Dom. So Seawark is going to have to work this other one down. Skugar better back it up. He actually is trying to go for touch of the Magi on that pet. No way. Going to be Arcana Sphere. Should be able to hit Skugar as well as the pet. I think the pet does get clipped by it. And Skugar still holding on to his flesh cap, still holding on to the shield. So it should be A-okay for now. Seawark just trying to build up himself a little bit of Arcane Power charges. Going to be a full Arcana Sphere. Knocking back Skugar. Does get himself big shields. Going to be interrupted on that Shadow. Stun from the pet was really early. So actually, Seawark, I think he's just going to focus on the pet. Looks like he's going to go for Touch of the Magic onto Skugar. No way for him to stop him. No pets available. Trying to go for maybe Fear. Seawark can just blink it away. Just go behind the pillar. Just trying to ignore the fear as best as possible. Continue just to get whatever damage he can to Skugar. Does not have a trouble for this flash gun. Just continue to get as much damage as he can. Trying not to get interrupted on his Arcane. But he's slowly but surely blasted through that shield. Should be able to interrupt that fed summon. Gonna be Arcane Blast off of the Kevin Slime. Looks like Kevin is disappearing. Gonna be another Rupali. Does Seawark go for a Cannon Sphere? No, looks like he's gonna go for Arcane Blast over in the Mage with the Orb, with the Missiles. Again, trying not to get interrupted as best as he can. Summon Felguard, definitely is gonna have an interrupt for it. Blink into an interrupt. Dude, not even letting him play. The Warlock is behind. He needs to get his sped up and running. He needs to do something. He needs some sort of CC or just needs to use Wall. Find a way to just deal with Seawark. Maybe just throw him in a Fear. Mortal Coil. Maybe just to fear him. Seawark actually, out of the Mortal Coil, did it Trinket? Shadow Fury? Oh, hits up with Polymorph before that. Seawark doesn't have the biggest burst, but that's going to be a Dark Pack for Skugar. He's going to get himself a shield. I don't know what Petty is sacrificed for the shield. Maybe one of the Imps. But he is should be sacrificing one of his... Normally, you sacrifice 8 pets. I guess your main commanding pet's health. In order to get a shield, but I think he basically sacrificed his own health for that Dark Pack shield. Try to get another Felguard up and running and summon back up. Gonna be Flesh Cap. Commune to Fear. Seawork actually put himself in a great position. immune that fear. Gonna be some Arcane Blast. Maybe Skugar can go for an interrupt. It's gonna just destroy these imps. And Skugar, ooh, Seamark does get himself a big blast with the Deathborn. Got himself Arcane Power rolling as well. Gonna be Decimated Bolt onto the Mage. But Skugar, he's trying to get Shadow Bolts in. He's got some random pets getting summoned up. But those things are not going to be as good as a Felgar. Big Barrage on Seaver trying to make the most damage happen. Does he have a big PIs? Or rather, Palms? Presence of Mind for big Arcane Blast? I don't think he does. Both of them are kind of low. Skugar does get himself a pet resummon. Was that a Felgar? That might have been with a Feldam. I'm not sure if he did get Feldam back or not. But Seamark with an Abyss, big barrage and all those pets. It looks so awesome. Flesh kept getting interrupted. Look at all those imps just getting blasted. He has a lot of pets, but he can't go for like a Tyrant or anything. Gonna be the Arcanosphere. Skugar slowed down. Oh, does port it. He does try to juke it. Well done. Seamark is kind of low on health himself. He's in about half-ish. That pet is finally in play. Can go for the Axe Toss. So it's gonna be something for Skugar to worry about. Also not worrying about his pet's health as well. He has all those imps behind him. He has all those pets back there. Also, how do you accumulate that many imps? How are they not disappearing by now? Mortal Call into Seaver, trying to go for Decimated Bolt. Stun around the corner. Skugar is going to have to re-Decimated Bolt if possible. It's going to send in even more Demon Doggos. I don't think this guy is running tier set. Maybe he's running tier set for the triple dogs, but that's about it. Seaver again with a Deathborn, 50% more damage. Could just go blasting out the pets. Going to be the Tyrant joining into the fight. Skugar is trying to keep his main Felguard pet alive. And Seamark is harassing the pet. Now chooses to harass Skugar instead. Touching the magic, blink and run to big barrage. Skugar, oh! I think he actually set him on fire with a fire blast at the end. Just snapped his fingers and the man combusted. This Arcane Mage doing work. Gotta be Knuckles up next. Quick imprison onto Seamark. Are we playing a, what kind of I was gonna say Necrolord? Demon Hunter maybe? No, Venthyr. Was that a Venthyr? That was so Venthyr. Definitely needs to get an IBM on Seaverk. Gonna get interrupted. Oh, maybe he can go for a Metamorphosis. Stun Seaverk, get himself another IBM. He definitely needs to get himself an IBM if he wants to go for like a full dot damage onto Seaverk. But it is also gonna be the brand. If he can extend the brand, that's gonna not only reduce the cast time of Seaverk's abilities. Oh, Knuckles going in for a Metamorphosis, but not on top of Seaverk. Just kind of going using Metamorphosis in place. That is gonna lose him out on Silver Brand usage, which is going to be super unfortunate. Slow down, can't really do much. Having to waddle towards Seaverk, trying to see if he can find him, but he can't really go anywhere. Trying to go for yet another I-beam, but he's just getting interrupted over and over. Man. Knuckles trying to see if he can charge in, close the gap. Seaverk does get a big Deathborn and just collapses the big touch of the Magi. For like a slap of the Magi, what the? Arhi's gonna be up next. There's no way. I don't know if Seaverk has enough here to beat Arhi. Like, so far, for Seaverk, he's done a fantastic job. Incredible job of trying to survive as best as he can as an Arcane Mage versus all these Shamans, but that seems to be such a hard counter class for him. He's got He's got Purges, so you can just remove his buffs completely. He got Wall. He got Earth Elemental. He got Ranged Damage. He got a Ranged Interrupt. He got so many Interrupts. It's not even funny. Poly by Seaverk, trying to see if he can maybe get a CC onto Arhi. He does have a Grounding Totem that stops, or also Grounding Totem. That will just stop a lot of the bursts out of Seaverk. Also, he has interrupts like Sunder, as well as a Stun Totem. Which if he goes Sunder into a Stun, that can be pretty deadly. It's just mini interrupts in between. Seaverk just can't even get a cast off. Trying to do best he can. Finally gets a Poly. Gonna be Arcanosphere. And Arhi just trinkets out of it and interrupts Seaverk. Hits him with the LE Blast and just disrespects him with a Sunder at the end. There's only so much you can do. Wait, what happened to Team 2? The whole Team 2 just bailed. Looks like Lazy Purr is going to get in there. Try to see if he can take down Arhi. Arhi with that wall, trying to get as much healing as he can. But that's going to be full dots rolling on him with a tier set for Lazy Purr. Got himself the big Berserk Bleed on top of the Lycurian Burst, trying to get the back-to-back bites. Man, the whole Team 2 left. I think they were expecting for Seaver to be able to 1v5 it, huh? Damn. And Arhi trying to get himself a bit of Maelstrom. We're only at 30% dampening, which is a pretty high dampening. But for Shaman, yeah, man, it's not that high. He has plenty of healing. Doesn't really have the Maelstrom in order to top himself off, though. Might be in a bit of trouble. Definitely needs the Maelstrom together with that Healing Stream Totem. Does not get the Maelstrom at all, as Lazy Purr does lock him down with the dam. Lazy Purr finally has his conduits working, too. So prior to this, he didn't really have a working conduit. So now his damage should be a little bit better. I don't know what conduits he would run as a feral, but I guess anything that does your damage, right? anything and everything that does you damage. Try to see if he can get out of the static link totem, but he can't copy. He's playing out that Necrolord enhancement. Big zaps onto Lazypur, which is going to send him behind a little bit. Trying to give himself a bit of healing. As he's playing the Restoration Affinity, going to be the rejuves, regrowths, and swift mends. Maybe even a wild growth in order to keep himself topped off. Just trying to keep himself alive as best as possible. And copy, just putting in pressure onto Lazy. Lazy barely any health. Does get himself Thorns, as well as big Curing Birds. Copy from the Earth Shaman. It's going to be a Stone to copy. Going to be a trinket for it. And Lazy is going to have to go for a bit of a reset. Does have a wall if he needs to. Looks like he tried to go for a reset. I don't think he's going to be able to get away from the Earth Elemental as well as the Shaman. That's a lot of mobility out of the two. Earth Elemental is pretty persistent. The Shaman is also not going to let you go anywhere. Interrupt the copy on nature. Does copy have a Fleshcraft? That's another question. Will copy begin a flesh cut sometime soon? Lazypur trying to go for a big Mamo to copy. Maybe he could go for back-to-back bites. Copy does give himself a bit of recovery, 40% damage, but it's still healing a ton. I think even without an Urshield totem or Urshield. But it's kind of nuts. Dropping down the healing stream in order to get him some sub-survivability. Going to be a stun totem missed by Lazy. As he's just been trying to get out of the static totem. Just getting booped around the chain. That is so rough. And copy, trying to continue to heal himself as best as possible, trying to keep himself topped off as much as he can. Fleshcraft getting quick intro, but Lazy. Does Lazy have enough damage here? Berserk is back up, full bleeds. Copy, do you survive this with a wall? With main man, that bleed the damn out of the kitty. That is a lot, dude. I think Teamwork and Lazy are just a two-man show right here. The rest of the team, too, about he's probably got a 1v5. But you're like, you know what? No, I'll let Lazy play as well. Man.